and they're here tonight. Please welcome PIG STY!
So I don't know what to do with my hands. We're just gonna put them here. First and foremost, my name is Elsa. Yes, like the Disney animated movie Frozen. No, I do not want to build a snowman. Please stop asking me that. It's really tough being named after a Disney princess. I don't know if there's any Cinderella's or Mulan's here. I don't know if anyone has ever had to crush a child's dreams. But last week, my boss brought his daughter into work and it said, Cindy, this is Elsa. And her face exploded. You're Elsa? And I was like, yeah. I'm also Santa. She's gotta learn early. I'm really happy to be here, you guys. I'm having a really rough week, so I'm happy to be here. I just got fired from the organic pet food store. Yeah, that is a real sentence. Thank you. What type of place is the organic pet food store? That's the type of place where you wait 3 weeks to see another black person. And you just gotta count yourself. Yeah. Apparently me and my people are not lining up for vegan dog food. That's just not a thing we buy. They fired me because I was not personable enough, which I thought was bullshit. They made me sell vegan dog food. It's cruel to me. I cannot pass that across the counter and smile at you. This lady comes in one day and she's like, hey, hi, hey, how's it going? I just got a new puppy. I'm vegan. I want to raise the new puppy vegan. What do you suggest? I was like, children. You probably have children, man. Wrong answer, you guys. That, yeah, that gets you fired. Before that, I worked at this office, right? And this is great because this was like my step up from like blue collar jobs to like white collar jobs. Like I had a cubicle and my own phone. And then after about a week, I realized, oh, this is why people kill themselves. Okay. I get it. Okay, cool. This was really exciting though, because this was also, the office was full of older 50 and 60 year old Jewish and Italian white ladies, and I got to play my favorite game. How long does it take for you to figure out I'm a girl? Forever! I eventually had to start making all these like weird moves to like the bathroom, you know? Like, ladies, this period, you know, right? Bros, how about those things? except for one lady, Stella. I also think Stella had a thing for the chocolate, because she would say some really weird shit, right? She'd be like, "Darling, oh my gosh, look at you, and that tie, and that skin tone, you don't know, darling. Oh, you don't know. Now, if you were just a few years older, oh, you don't know." I was like, "Oh, Stella, I don't think you know." Or maybe you do. Keep in mind, you guys, that that was also the voice of our receptionist. That's the first person you get on the phone when you call into our office. I'm like, "God damn, how did you get this job? Did you just pantomime your interview, man?" It's like, "Hello, thank you for calling the Brooklyn Reporter." It's like, "What is that, ma'am?" I was on a lunch break one time, and she caught me smoking it. Well, she didn't catch me smoking a cigarette. I'm a grown adult. But, she says, "Darling, oh my God, you've got to put those down. Let me tell you something." Now, I'm bracing for her how I quit smoking story, right? I shit you not, this is what this lady said. She says, "Darling, let me tell you something. Now listen, in my entire life, I have never smoked a cigarette. I had a cup of coffee in my entire life." I was like, "Well, what the fuck happened to your voice? Did you swallow a firecracker? Did you always sound like that, ma'am?" I'm like, "Ma, let me get a juice box." I worked at Taco Bell for a little while. When I say a little while, I do mean a week. If they had an Employee of the Week award, though, you guys, I would have won that shit, because I was the best burrito roller there was. They fired me because I kept licking them. Apparently that is frowned upon. But my burritos burnt slow and even. I smoke a lot of burritos. I've been smoking a lot of weed lately. I probably could not pass a piss test right now. I've been eating a lot of weed lately. Probably couldn't pass a poop test either. Hot and poop joke. They said it couldn't be done. I had to get used to smoking weed in New York, though, because I'm from the South. I'm from Virginia, so we just fucking smoke weed. But I forget that New York City has just like 1,000,001 police officers, and they just like to pop out of trash cans, repel out of trees. So like the other day, I was minding my own business, smoking a joint, walking down the street to the corner, get ready to cross the street, and I get a very aggressive tap on the shoulder. I look over, and it's a cop. And the joint is right here. So I was like, cool, freedom was fun. He immediately tries to like get buddy-buddy with me, you know? He's like, "Hey man, come on, what are you, do you smoke recreationally?" I was like, "Oh, Olympically?" He says, "Look, just do me a favor and just put that in the puddle before you cross the street." He says, "Yeah, just put it in the puddle before you cross the street." I was so shocked. I was like, "Just put it." And then, no lie, you guys, he let me walk away. I was like, this shit's a setup. I walked backwards for 5 blocks. It's just, are you sure? I'm black.
I knew this reference, but you better watch yourself, Missy. No a roaring about for you. If you cut yourself, I'm not gonna heal you. I know my name is Jesus Christ, but I'm not gonna heal you.
Mom, hurry, I'm starving.
Hand me that rake. You missed all these leaves.
It's just, they kept falling at a rapid pace. I don't know what to do. You're doing great at it, though.
Let me tell you something. I met your mother while I was raking.
Oh, that's cool, Dad.
Meeting any nice ladies?
Raking?
Yeah.
I just rake the backyard. Why would I rake somewhere else? Should I be raking somewhere else? Dad, is that what I should be doing?
Sure know how to rake, sugar.
Yeah.
Come over to my lawn.
Figure that, you know, you look lonely, and you got a lot of leaves on your lawn.
Desperately lonely, sweetheart. You could fill so many bags over here, oh.
So funny, figure I can do whatever you want. You go to school with me, right? I never heard you talk before, though. You sound so older.
Yeah, well, you know. My voice has always been like this since birth. So I play it up a bit.
Okay. All right, well.
Such strong arms.
Thank you. I'll break whatever I need to, you know?
Johnson, I'm sorry, but the prognosis came back positive. Your face exploded. Your face literally exploded off of your face. And I believe it's because of too much stress in your life. You're too excitable. And if this happens and continues, you're going to have other parts of your body completely explode off of your body. I'm going to set you up with some yoga. And a pack of green tea.
I can't heal your exploded face. I know my name is Jesus Christ. I can't actually just heal you like that.
God damn it.
That's my brother.
So it appears that your dog is very hot. That's what happened. Did he get into anything at all? Or?
Nothing other than what I gave him.
Oh, you didn't mention this. What did you give him exactly?
Oh my god! I got doggy weed. Snorted a line of doggy coke. I guess doggy weed and puppy pot would be a better term for that.
All
right. Whoa!
I didn't even test for doggy coke. I didn't know that was a thing. That's a thing.
What kind of veterinarian are you?
I'm sorry.
I bring my dog here.
I should have realized it.
Hey, whoa.
Okay, all right. So I'm going to recommend probably not giving so much.
tell me if you're a cop.
Gangwalking Patrol, Providence Police caught you.
Oh.
I saw you drop litter on the street.
I'm sorry, yeah, I had a Kleenex in there. I dropped it.
You were raking, sir? Not in this zone. No.
I am sorry.
Are you raking recreationally?
What's going on? Did you know your shoe was untied?
No!
No, I didn't. Is that illegal, too?
Lawbreaker!
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 Dangerous to yourself! Poof!
Come with me if you want to live. My name is Goddamn. You're about to eat that?
Yeah.
He definitely should eat that.
Yeah.
That looks great.
Thank you.
I don't know why you haven't started eating it yet.
Well, I'm just chalking it through. I just want to make sure I'm supported at all sides. I'm just saying, yeah, what are you saying?
It could make you sick. Oh.
Well, see, now I'm just not so sure.
It could make you sick
like,
in your tummy.
Like butt sick?
In your butt. It can make your whole butt sick.
My whole butt?
He's holding your whole butt. He's holding you back from your dreams. Butt sick isn't that bad. Butt sick's kind of fun. It's a chance to sit and rest.
Listen, buddy. We don't want what you're selling.
Well, I kind of do.
All right.
There's a small part of me that dies. I'm just curious.
You're the worst vegan dog food salesman ever.
The butt sick is fun for dogs.
Don't tell them they're going to get butt sick.
Dogs love butt sick. Have you ever seen an unhappy butt sick dog scooting along the floor?
Call it a cleanse.
A cleanse!
Call it a cleanse.
A butt cleanse.
Cleansing.
Hi, welcome to Trader Joe's. This is the health and beauty section.
Cool. I need to, you know, I've been eating a lot of ham.
Ham, the ham diet? You're on the ham, hold on. Ham 30?
I had a doctor who said ham. The ham 30. Too. Yeah. And, you know, I just, you know. Why would you eat it? Feel handy.
Okay.
And, yeah, they think some mandarins or like, I heard kale is a food.
Kale is a food. We've got cleanses here.
Cleanses?
Yeah, this is called Dr. Buttsick.
Yeah, this is a Taco Bell. It's where most people cleanse. We have a whole menu of our cleansing options. Recommend a chalupa. We also have a crack staff in the back. They roll the burritos so tight.
Kevin, you don't have to explain what Taco Bell is every time someone comes. It's a restaurant. It's been around for a long time. Most people understand.
Yeah, but we're not tapping into a market of diarrhea. Yes.
I know you're talking right now. I don't mean to bother you.
It's all right. So rude.
We are visiting, and we have never been in a
Tacobel.
All right. Well, we're here.
Welcome to Tacobel anal cleansing.
The N-word.
Okay.
I got you comfortable in the first place.
Nachos?
The other one. The problem with the N-word is that there is not a white people equivalent. There's not a thing that I can do to get you back, right? So what are the white people swears, right? Throw it out. What are the two?
Cracker.
Cracker. I don't like cracker. Okay. The reason why I don't like crackers is because crackers are delicious. Saltines, good in soup. Animals, those are cute and sweet. That doesn't work as an insult. What's the other one?
Honky.
I also don't like honky. That sounds like a child's birthday clown. You can't be mad at Honky, you know? Like, he's just trying to entertain. Kids, Honky's here. He's like, ah! He's like, okay. I heard one the other day that is just also too funny to you. Have we heard Mayo Face yet? I can't use that. I think I accidentally discovered, though, what might be close. I think I might have accidentally discovered this. The next time, Tarik, this. The next time a white person makes you mad, you look them right in the face and you call them a hipster. Oh, you guys hate that. Add the hard ER at the end. And it's cool, they're not gonna fight you, they're just gonna like go home and write a think piece. I don't know what you get angry, you call a congressman or something. I don't know. I've been trying to figure out what's going on right now. You know, up is down, left is right, right is racist. Everything is so weird right now, you guys. Did we really elect a giant bag of Thousand Island dressing? Is that and not the good shit either, like that Kraft shit that's just like, yo, it's too hard. It's when your mom like mixes the ketchup and the mayo together, and then like that's that. Your mom didn't do that. I gotta have a conversation with my mom. We weren't poor, that was just, she told me everyone did. Okay, all right. Here's the thing, right? I think Donald Trump is a good businessman if you were like me and you have a loose definition of the word good. But he has inspired me to start my new business, you guys, all right? I'm going to complete the hidden room in my apartment to hide all my Muslim friends. We're gonna call that Airbnb. There it is. I can't wrap my head around this Muslim ban, you know? Because like every Muslim I've ever met has been my friend. I know it because they tell me, hey, my friend! Friends, you guys. Except for one guy. The guy at my bodega, okay, you guys, like, the other day I went to my local bodega, because I know that word now. Bodega. I ordered a Philly sub. That's what I told the guy, says I would like a Philly sub. And he looked at me and says, sub? Sub? Oh, no, we don't make a sub here. It's heel. You know, from here. I was like, oh, you're not from here. You don't get to correct me with broken English. That's not how this, you can't come to Airbnb. I think the stupidest pro-Trump argument is that I like Trump because he talks like me. Which is retarded, you guys. I don't want a president that talks like me. I just said retarded. I use fuck ton as a unit of measurement. That's not a real thing. Uh, I mean, okay, and like, this is not any sort of like ringing endorsement of Hillary either. Like, okay, like I was with her, right? But like, I was with her like the same way a guy is at the bar with his really drunk girlfriend, you know? Like, I am so sorry. I'm with her. It's... no, it's okay. We're gonna leave, actually. It's all right. We're gonna... So I don't take you out. Let's go. I'm with her. It's all right. It's all right. I think part of our problem, right? I think part of our problem is that we are not doing enough to learn about each other, you know? So, like, my mission this year is to try to do what I can to learn about white people. I do a lot of these things, you know? community outreach, you know? Been doing a lot of cat sitting lately. That's a great cultural exchange, okay? Because I get to live in a white person's house, eat their food, steal their change. I love when white people lie to me and say their cat doesn't bite. I lie back and say I don't kick cats. You know, it's a cultural exchange. You know? I'm dating interracially now. Okay, and you do, you learn a lot. That's a weird thing for you to woo for. That's strange. You learn a lot when you do this. Here, check this out. I'll leave you guys with this fast fact. I don't know if you guys know this or not. Fast fact, me and my white girlfriend, we are not allowed to play fight in public. No, we cannot do it. It's a tense racial climate right now. Nobody thinks that's cute. If we're in the hood, then it's like, yo, son, what's good? Yo, that motherfucker white lady messing with you, motherfucking gentrifier, yo, we got you. It's like, whoa, everybody relax, it's cool. I brought her with me, she's cool, she's great. If we are literally anywhere else, it's like, oh my God, ma'am, is that black man attacking you? It's okay, don't all. Yeah, okay. That's cool, that's what I got. All right. Yeah.
I had no idea you were this good of an actor. I had no idea.
Shut up, that's the first time you've said something about my acting.
Yeah, I know. Our whole relationship, I told you that acting is a dead end. But now I believe that you can do it. I think you can do it.
So you guys, you fuck and then you go into your separate beds.
He needs to debrief after his performances. He gives himself notes. He evaluates the tape, and then he just takes headshots for hours. Like post fake orgasm headshots. I support him. I love him.
No. I support your relationship. I think this is great. I think I'm gonna bring two beds into my bedroom.
Wait.
I think I'm gonna do it.
Oh my God.
I really do have a miracle whip face. It just doesn't make any sense.
I've been dreading this day.
You've known, Delia?
Yes.
You've known that I've had a miracle whip face for 27 years? When were you going to tell me? When somebody just decided that whoever liked me was a monster?
I just thought I'd die first. I'm sorry, you... Children walk by you and want to rub ice cream cones on your face.
Oh. That's my cheekbone. You're going to disrupt the symmetry of my face that I've been shellacking all morning with a butter knife? Please stop.
Sandwich is a little dry.
I'm a monster!
Stop that crime. Stop that crime right now.
Making the whip run.
Look at me. Come here.
Oh, I hit him.
You were beautiful. You were delicious. And you were powerful. Miracle whip. You are a miracle, and you crack like lightning. So, I don't want to see you crying in here no more.
Okay.
All right?
It's only going to be Miracle Whip from now on. I'm going to be a positive source.
Now, you give your auntie Nutella a kiss on the cheek.
All right, this is my apartment. It's totally barren. Am I poor enough for you?
You're just poor enough.
Yeah, just poor enough?
Just poor enough.
Because you said that you didn't want a lavish life, you didn't want a lavish relationship, so I sold everything, made a ton of money off of it, and just gave it all away, and now I'm a poor person.
Wait, you gave it away?
You wanted me to be poor!
I wanted you to be minimalistic and save so we could get out of here!
Yeah.
Hi, I'm here for the Craigslist, I need those chairs.
Yeah. What
the hell? Derek, what the hell?
Yeah, you need to communicate better!
Are you kidding
me? Yeah, because you were confusing
earlier. Wait. Can we have one chair?
Are you going to break a Craigslist bond?
Yes!
Tea room.
Your tea room? He has a tea room, Derek!
Yeah, I did too! I think I sold it to him!
Hi, I'm the nearsighted guy from Craigslist. Can I just grab these?
Derek, I got you those wooden poker for Christmas!
Ready?
Ha ha ha!